Hey guys, so welcome back to my channel. I know I have been MIA for over a year now, and it's because my 1.5 year old son has been keeping me completely busy. He's been keeping me on my toes like all year round, but I am back now. I will be trying to upload a video at least once a week, so do hit the notification bell to get notified of all my videos. So today I will be swatching and reviewing for you guys the Faces Canada No Transfer Matte Lipstick. Now these come in 12 different shades, and I've got 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 of them. So let's start. Say what you need to say to me, baby. Use your words, express your ways to me, baby. We in the slow, participate with me, baby. Communicate with me, baby. Say what you need to say to me, baby. Use your words, express your ways to me, baby. We starting fresh, it's a new day with me, baby. We trying to build up. Fuck the fake, I want the real love. Let it out, don't keep it sealed up. I know you got a lot to deal with. I know you work hard, and I'm not here to pull the wrong card. I just wanna be a sweetheart, hype you up and make you feel good. We alright, we alright, we okay. Things are gonna get better, cause I'm lighting the way. Sometimes you don't feel like talking and I give you your space. Just know that I'll be right here waiting when you're ready to play. Communicate with me, baby. Say what you need to say to me, baby. Use your words, express your ways to me, baby. We in the slow, participate with me, baby. Communicate with me, baby. Say what you need to say to me, baby. Use your words, express your ways to me, baby. We starting fresh, it's a new day with me, baby. I'm gonna lift you up until the sky is falling. Don't push me away because your heart is calling. I could give a fuck if you were broke about it. I'm trying to aim for trust, it ain't no easy target. The people in your past did you dead. This is the shade number 6, Tea Spiller. This is a nice pretty pink shade, which I feel is going to suit all skin tone. Once it dries down, it looks kind of like a mauvey pink. It's not as bright as it's catching on the camera, but it's a pretty nice pink color. This next shade is called number 09, Serial Texture. This shade is a darker pink with purpley undertones to it. You can see it's quite nice, will suit most of the skin tones. It looks a bit like magenta rather than, you know, like a fuchsia pink. I think it is a magenta, but it's overall, it's a nice shade and I like it better than Tea Spiller shade. This next shade is called number 02 Influencer. This is a bright orangey red. This shade in particular was very patchy, streaky, and quite sheer. It was very difficult for me to work with. You can see over here I've layered it a lot more times than over here. And this is like not one of my favorites. Like, I don't really like this shade. So yeah, this was the shade number 02 Influencer. This is the shade number 03 B-Town Babe. This is sort of like an orange red, like a tomato red. You can see it's much more red compared to Influencer, number 02 Influencer. If you like warm reds, then you will like this shade. But I do not like, personally, I do not like warm reds. They tend to make my teeth look yellow. And I feel like my complexion looks more dull. Not dark, but more dull when I apply orange-based red. So I tend to keep away from those kind of reds. But if you are like a person who loves warm-toned red, then you are going to love this shade. It's a nice summer shade. So yeah, this was the shade B-Town Babe. This is the shade number 04 Wonderbug. You can see that it's more deeper, darker than the other two red shades. This one was more like an orangey tone. This one was more like a watermelon red. And this is more like a classic red. So this is finally a shade that you know, I can work with. It will suit all types of skin tones. So yeah, this was the shade number 04 Wonderbug. This is the shade number 05 Silent Stalker. This is more red, like a more deeper red compared to the shade number 04 Wonderbug.
Again, I think I like this shade better than Wonderbug, but this was more sheer compared to Wonderbug. But I do like this shade. I mean, I see nothing wrong with it. It is less bright compared to Wonderbug, more subtler, but maybe that is because it was a bit sheer compared to Wonderbug. I'm not really sure. But yeah, this was the shade number 05, Silent Stalker. This is the shade number 01, FOMO Queen, and this is the only shade that I love. Okay, there are a few shades that I liked, but this is the only shade that I loved amongst the 8 shades that I have. And this is a very nice deep red shade. It has got a slight bit of pink undertone to it, a very tiny slight bit of pink undertone to it. And because of the pigmentation on my lips, it's looking even more darker. It looks amazing on my skin tones. I feel that it will look amazing across the skin tones. It will brighten up your complexion. And if you have to have at least one shade from this collection, then I would definitely recommend you to go for this number 01 FOMO Queen. So yeah, moving on to the next. This is the shade number 12, Gramo Nazi, and I think I need to correct myself that FOMO Queen was the only shade that I loved, but there are two shades in this range that I love, which are FOMO Queen and Gramo Nazi. This is a very nice deep red beetroot shade, sort of. It's got like a bit of red in it. I think it's more like a wine shade, you know what I mean? Like a really nice deep dark wine shade, a very nice shade for, you know, an evening out or a dinner date or something like that, or whenever the heck you want to wear it. I mean, there are no restrictions on when you wear a shade. It's just one of those things. It's like really, really, really pretty. It will suit all skin tones, but I feel like it will look exceptionally stunning on our skin tone. So yeah, this was the shade number 12, Gramo Nazi. So that was it for the swatches, guys. Now for the review. These lipsticks retail for an MRP of $4.99 for 3.5 ml of product, which I feel is a little bit expensive. There are discounts all over. I think probably, I'm pretty sure, I've not really checked, but I'm pretty sure there'll be discounts on Nykaa as well on these lipsticks. Now on the website, they have mentioned, on the Faces Canada website, they have mentioned that the reasons to buy are intense color payoff in single swipe, which I feel is true. Then highly pigmented, yes, but highly pigmented and intense color payoff, I think they are like one and the same point. Next, smudge proof, transfer proof and long lasting, which is true. They last for about 6 to 8 hours, I mean, obviously oily meal excluded. If you have anything oily, then they will not last as long. I mean, they will fade away from the middle of your lips. Then the fourth point is enriched with moisturizing chamomile oil. And the next one is that they are paraben free, which is always good. And the last reason to buy them mentioned is that because they come in 12 stunning shades. Now for my review. I feel that if you're not a fan of wearing lip balm or moisturizing your lips or scrubbing your lips before you apply any lipstick, especially any liquid lipstick, then this is a complete no-no for you. I mean, these lipsticks are a complete no-no for you, because with these lipsticks, you have to scrub your lips first, then moisturize your lips, and then apply these lipsticks, because if you do not, then they are going to be drying as heck. They're going to be like really, really, really drying. Another thing that I did not like is that they are very crumbly when you want to layer them. Sometimes some of the shades were quite sheer, especially when you apply them over moisturized lips. I felt that they went a bit sheer. So when I tried to layer them, I found them to be quite crumbly after the first layer was dried. And I think they are not meant for layering, because they have mentioned that it has intense color payoff in a single swipe. So when they say single swipe, I don't think they want you to layer the lipstick or anything like that. So I had to start from scratch. Like, I had to wipe the entire lipstick off and then apply it again in a smooth layer. So I found them little bit difficult to work with when I wanted to layer them. That is something that I did not like about this lipstick. Yeah, those were the things that I had a problem with. Apart from that, I do think that the lipsticks are good. Most of them are red, which I feel like the brand's intention must be so that each and every complexion can find their own red or something like that. But they are good summer shades. You can see over here, I have 8 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them are shades of red. So that was it for my review, and I can't really think of anything that I must have missed out. But if you want to know anything more about these lipsticks, then please do leave a comment in the comment section, and I will try and answer all the comments as and when I get time. So yeah, if you're not subscribed to my channel yet, please do subscribe, and if you have not clicked on the notification bell yet, please do click on the notification bell to get notified of all my videos, and I will see you in my next video. Till then, bye bye.